Hi friends, welcome to SPJK TechnoSolved, your one-stop training and AMP education platform. In this video you are going to learn about types of software. What is system software? Under system software we discuss about operating system, language processor, utility software. Application software? Under application software we discuss about general purpose application software, specific purpose application software. You will receive more updated videos on CBSE Computer Science syllabus videos, so do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get the new videos at your fingertips. Happy learning, viewers.
Hello everyone, welcome to our channel SPJK TechnoSoft. Today we are going to learn types of software. In this session the contents to be covered: types of softwares, those are two types, system software and application software. Again, these are classified into different types. Next, software. Before going to know about the software, we have some examples. As a human being, we all know how to perform our day-to-day activities and how to react in certain situations. For example, when we feel hungry, we eat. When we get tired of walking, we sit down. When we touch something extremely hot, we immediately remove our hand. Have you ever thought, how do we know what to do in the situations? It is the brain that gave instructions to act and react in this manner. Similarly, the computer gets all the instructions from the software to perform various tasks. This diagram shows the computer gets all the instructions from the software to perform various tasks, right? Next, coming to the hardware and software. In this diagram, it shows hardware devices: mouse, keyboard, printer, monitor. These all are hardware devices. These hardware devices are working. How the instructions coming from the software? The softwares are examples: FB, email, YouTube, Word, etc. Right? And the below diagram. This diagram shows a computer is a machine that doesn't get any intelligence of its own. By getting the software instructions, it's working. Right? Next, this diagram shows a computer without instructions is like a car without an engine. Next, this diagram shows it requires a set of instructions given by user to work on. These set of instructions are called programs, which are written in the computer languages. Software is a collection of programs run on the computer hardware and helps us to work on the computer. The software is a part of the computer which we cannot touch and feel. Next, coming to the types of software. This diagram shows the classification of software. The software can be divided into two types: software, system software and application software. Again, the system software classified into three types: operating system, language processor, utility software. And application software again divided into two types: general purpose application software and specific purpose application software. We will see the dip. Coming to the system software. System software is defined as a collection of programs that controls the core applications and internal working in our computer system. It reads data from the input device and transfers the processed information to output devices. This diagram shows collection of programs that controls the all our applications. Right? These all are OSs, softwares. This diagram shows the computer receives the data from input device and processes it into computer and gave it to the output device. Right? Next, operating system is one of the system software. An operating system is needed to operate the computer. It controls the overall activities of computer. It acts as an interface between the user and hardware and enables them to work together. The OS acts as an interface between users and hardware. Right? User hardware. Operating system is an interface between these things, right? Operating system is an interface between these things and enables them to work together, right? Next, these are the example operating systems. MS-DOS is an OS, Windows XP is one of the OS, Windows 7, Windows 8 operating system, Unix and Linux operating system. These all are the operating system. When the computer is switched on the OS, the OS is the first program that gets loaded in its memory. This diagram shows the computer is switched on. The OS is the first program that gets loaded in its memory, like this. Right? Example, OS is like a principal of our college or school. The principal has various responsibilities to manage the school, like supervising the students and supervising the teachers, etc. In the same way, an operating system performs various functions to manage the working of a computer. These all are various operating systems. Next, coming to the functions of the operating system. First one is processor management. An operating system manages the working of the processor by allocating various jobs to it. This is the processor management. And memory management, it assigns memory to various programs whenever required. It also frees up memory when it is not in use. Right? Coming to the device management, an operating system controls the working of all input and output devices. Storage management manages and controls the storage device to provide space to program for execution and data save. Application interface. In this, API stands for Application Programming Interface, provide a way for applications to make use of hardware. User interface, structure for interaction between a user and the computer. Next, coming to the types of OS. In these types of OS, mainly we have three major types: single user, multi-user and multitasking. When coming to the single user OS allows only one user to use computer system at any given time. Coming to the multi-user, a multi-user operating system allows multiple users on different computers to access a system at the same time. These computers are connected to the computer through a network. When coming to the multitasking OS allows a user to run more than one application programs at the same time. In multitasking, the OS keeps track of the program you are in and allows you to switch from one program to another without losing information. Without losing any information, it allows you to switch from one program to another. Next, utility software is one of the system software. Utility software performs specific tasks usually related to managing a computer, its device or its programs. These all are utility programs. Okay? That is deleting data, data defragmentation, user security and antivirus and software updaters and system cleanup and encryption and decryption and formatting. These all are utility programs. These programs assist in the smooth functionalities of the computer system and help it to perform better. Some utilities help you to avoid virus attack. Let's see. What are those? First one is backup. Backup utility. The backup utility enables backing up of files, folders, database or complete disks. This diagram shows the process of the backup. Okay. Is a process of storing a copy of data in another storage device that it can be recovered and restored in case of damage or loss of the original data files. Data loss is very common, and has caused serious problems for many organizations and individuals. Hence, it is essential to have regular data from time to time. The next utility is file management tools. these all are file managers: Astro, CX File Explorer, Explorer, File Manager, FX, File Space, File Manager, Explore, etc. These all are file managers. Okay, it helps to perform operations on files such as viewing, editing, copying, and deleting. The next utility is antivirus. Antivirus, you can scan the drives, pen drives, and system by using antivirus softwares. These all are antivirus softwares like Avera, Avaste, Webroot, etc. These all are antivirus softwares. This diagram shows antivirus scanning process. It scans the files, drives, pen drives, etc. Next utility is compression. Compression tools are utilities that assist operating systems in shortening files so that they take less place. Okay, we can reduce the size by compressing the files. It is a process that shrinks files so that less disk space is occupied. The files that are bigger in size need to be compressed while sending as an email attachment. This is the compressing process, and these are the compressor softwares to compress the data or to reduce the file size. Next, language processor or programming language. This is one of the system software, and language processor, each software is created by writing programs. Some of the popular languages are C, C++, Java. These all are programming languages, but most popular languages are three: C, C++, Java. Right? As we know that computer can understand machine language, which comprises zeros and ones. Right? Therefore, programs written in these all programming languages cannot be recognized by computer. Here, a language processor plays a vital role in translation the programming language into machine language. This diagram shows the computer cannot understand the languages whatever the user given, that is high level language, but the computer only understand the machine level language. Those are binary format, those are ones and zeros. The language processors are two types: compilers and interpreters. First one is compiler. The compiler, it converts the high level language code to machine code in one session. It takes time because it have to translate high level code to lower level machine language all at once and then save the executable object code to memory. Right? Compiler is a translator program that converts the whole program into equivalent machine code in one step. It generates the object code for the program along with the list of errors. Okay? Source code is the high level language, object code is the machine level language. The compiler converts the source code into object code. This is the format of binary, zeros and ones, the machine understandable language. Next, coming to the interpreter, it translates the program line by line and simultaneously executes the converted line. If any error is found, it displays the error and doesn't proceed until the error is rectified. This diagram shows the interpreter. One line of high level source code comes to the interpreter. The interpreter transfers it to the output temperature. Next, coming to the differences between compiler and interpreter. These are some variations or differences between compiler and interpreter. The compiler scans the whole program in one step, but the interpreter translates program one statement by one statement, right? One statement at a time. In the compiler, main advantage of compilers is its execution time. Right? In the compiler, main advantage is execution time. In interpreter, due to interpreters being slow in executing the object code, it is preferred less. In the compiler, the errors are shown at the end together, but in the interpreter, errors are shown line by line. Example, compiler language C, C++, C#, etc. an interpreter example language like Python, Ruby, Perl, MATLAB, etc. Next, coming to the application software. Application software are the set of programs developed by programmers in order to perform specific types of jobs. Right? These all are application softwares. These all are done by programming languages by programmers. The programmer creates the softwares by using programming languages. Right? For examples, doing calculations, beautifications, documents. Okay? These are the examples. Are the specific purpose to create a particular software. Next. In this application software, we have two types. First one is general purpose application software. In this general purpose application software, this software can perform many tasks to fulfill the general needs of user. Okay, one of the example is DBMS. This process shows the DBMS. It helps us to arrange and store a large amount of information in an organized manner. We can create, add, find, sort, update, search, print and retrieve the information stored in the database. First we can create database and store the information in that, and later on as we retrieve the information by using commands. This is the database. Next, specific purpose application software. In this specific purpose software, which redesigned for a specific task. Okay, the softwares which are redesigned for specific tasks. And this we have taken two examples. Those are web browser and Tally and Busy. Okay, web browser is a specific purpose application software for retrieving and presenting and traversing information resources on the World Wide Web. By using these web browsers, we can presenting, retrieving and traversing information on the World Wide Web. Those web browsers are Opera, Google Chrome, Safari, Mozilla Firefox, Internet Explorer and Microsoft Edge. Right? Next, coming to the Tally and Busy. These type of softwares are also known as special purpose application softwares, which are redesigned for specific tasks. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned on this channel to get next upcoming video on memory units and the computer system organization. Thank you. Thanks for watching.
Thank you, viewers, for your time. Don't forget to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get latest trending technology and academic related videos. For any further queries, please reach us at info@spjktechnosoft.com. Please like, share and subscribe our channel. Thank you and goodbye.
Watching.